all door pole mounted enclosure is very frequently used right now in our industrial, in the telecom. But I think in the future we have more and more scenario we can see them, you know. The typical scenario you can see is we put the base station power backup system, like outdoor UPS on the pole. In this scenario, like normally what you can see is the small cell deployment right now. For example, the small cell put on pole, and you probably have two or three cells. Then every cell cover 120 degree. I think in the industrial, if you are in the telecom industry, we know it. In these scenarios, you need the pole mounted outdoor UPS, which is outdoor enclosure. But for this kind of scenario, normally the rated power could be 500 watts, 1,500 watts, 2,000 watts, even 3,000 watts. Depends on the small cell's rated power. But some scenario for the small cell, probably you need a solar system, because some scenario we saw that our customer deployed the small cell in some rural area without the electricity. You also can face the scenario that you have video surveillance, you have some Wi-Fi API deployed on the pole, and you need the pole mounted enclosure to provide the power backup and the network backhaul. You know, but in the end, you can also find a lot of scenarios. But the most important is for the pole mounted enclosure, we should really be careful that several parts. First, the installation must be easy. Because if you install an enclosure on the pole, remember it will be very high, like 5 meters or something, or 6 meters, very high, right? So it's not that easy to install. So if you make a very heavy system, too heavy to put on the pole, first, I guess is you cannot install by the one people. You have to use a crane something to put it on the pole, and that installation cost you should be careful. On the other hand, because if the system is too big, in the future the maintenance and this kind of things will make the things complex. So how to make a correct pole mounted enclosure, which it really depends on the scenario, and then we should try to make the system as small as possible. Try to make the system maintenance free. Try to make the installation easy, and one guy can finish the job. I know some scenario probably is not possible. For example, the small cells, you have 2,000 watts, 3,000 watts scenario, you need a long battery backup, and that's not possible. But still, try to make it small. But by the way, the small cell scenario, if you have 3,000 watts, for example, this kind of scenario, there's another very good idea that we did in China is we can bury the battery system in the under the ground. When you bury the system underground, you don't have a cooling problem. Second, you don't have to put the battery cabinet in a very high place. In the end, if you provide the enclosure with 300 watts to the small cell, this kind of scenario, although the rated power is very high, 300 watts, but the UPS system itself will not be big. The big part is the battery, right? So if you put it on the ground, it will be a very good idea. So in the end, we have a lot of different cases, you know. So what I want to say is the pole mounted enclosure is very common, you know, we can see, but case by case is different. So please don't use the traditional way of think about it. So let's talk and let's find a good way to fix a job, and you know, just like the underground things, underground battery something, it's also a good idea, right? So that's what I want to say for this part, okay?